Today's session we will discuss about the ribbon customizations. Okay.
Okay.
So basically we have a three types of ribbons. So first one is a home ribbons. Second one is the form.
Okay.
Third one is the subgrid ribbons. So the first one, home level ribbons. So when we navigate the entity, so here we can see the some buttons. Okay, new, delete, email. Okay, so run report. So these all the buttons we will call as the home ribbons. Okay, so for example, if you go to the okay, go open the any record. Okay, so it will in the form level. Okay, whatever the records you are seeing. Okay, so there in the form you can see the ribbons. Okay, so these all the ribbons. Okay, so we'll call as the form level ribbons. Okay, so in the subgrid ribbons, so if you place the any subgrid on the, so here if I click on it, this is a subgrid. If you click on here, so it will load the subgrid. Hello. 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 We have a three ribbons, three different kind of a ribbons. So that is home, form, subgrid. Okay. So for this customizing the ribbons. Okay. So first we have to import the, we have to export the solution. Okay. So go to the settings. Okay. So next one, solutions. Okay, create a separate solution. Okay, and here create a separate solution. Okay, so just enter the, just I'm giving a solution name, ribbon customizations. So here the publisher, so just I'm giving you some default publisher. So save. So for example, if you want to customize the which entity. Okay, so for example, I want to customize some contact entity. Okay, so just that entity. I want to customize the contact entity. Add to the solution. Okay, so save and close. Okay, and export the solution. So export the solution. So say here we can see the three things. Okay. So just I'm opening this one. Okay. So just extract this one solution file. So open this one. Here we can see the three files in the solution. So open the customizations.xml. So just I'm open with, I'm opening with Visual Studio. So basically in this customizations.xml file, it will contain the one tag. So that is a tag is called as a trip diff. Okay. So here on under the customization.xml, we will have a tag like a ribbon div. Okay. So div. So this is a root tag. So all the ribbon customizations for each and entity, it will contain, it will inside of this tag only. Okay. Control F here. Okay. Search for the tag rib. Okay. So here we can see. Okay. So here this ribbon definition tag. So all the ribbon customizations you have to do in this tag only. Okay. So normally, so the, it will contain the tags like a ribbon definition. If I copy this one into a separate thing. Okay. So in another notepad I will copy. Okay. So here we'll have a tag like a ribbon definition. So all the ribbon customizations for each and every entity, it will be under this tag only. Okay. So here we can see the some other tags, custom actions and templates. Okay. And command UI definitions and rule definitions. Okay. So and tab definitions. Okay. Tab. So display under the rule definitions only we will have another three tags. Okay. So next tag is the local tags. Okay. So here the first thing, this is the syntax of the ribbon customizations. Okay. So the main tag is the ribbon definition tag. Under this one, okay, under the definition tag we'll have a ribbon customizations tag. Okay, custom actions. So the custom actions tag, under this we have a templates, under this we have a command definition, under this we have a rule definitions, and under the rule definition we have a tab display rules, display rules and enable rules. So again we have a lock variables, and here we are closing a rib definition XML. Okay. So this is the main tags we have. Okay. So generally we, in the old fashion, we will manually we will do the all these customizations and all. Okay. So we have some syntaxes and all, we will do the manual coding. So now we have a tool, is a ribbon workbench. So it was suggested by the Microsoft itself. Okay. So for the most of the times we use the ribbon workbench tool for the ribbon customizations. Okay. So for the ribbon customizations, so go to the Google. Okay. So here we can search for the ribbon workbench. Ribbon workbench. Okay, so we can download for whichever the version you are working. For a 2011 we can download, and 2013 and here we can download it. Okay, so you can just enter the name and mail ID. Okay, so just if we click on this, it will start downloading the solution file. Okay, so this solution file we want to import it again. Okay, so I have already imported this ribbon workbench solution. Okay, so just we can import, so click on import and select the solution whatever you downloaded and click on next and it will import it. So once it is imported, here we can see the ribbon workbench tool. So if you click on that, okay, so it will give the pop-up window and it will loading the tool, it is loading. Okay, so it will ask for the solution. So I am giving it, this is a ribbon customization solution I am selected. So once we click on OK, so it will download the solution into the workbench. Okay, so here you can see the, for this entity, contact entity. So this is a home level ribbons and subgrid level ribbons and form level ribbons. For example, I want to add some button to the here. Okay, so here we can see that this is a controls. Okay, so tab. So here if you see this one is a tab. Okay, so here this up to here to the form, it's a group. So this is a tab. Okay, so up to delete it's a tab, up to here it's a group. Okay, so for example, the most of the times we will work for the adding a buttons. Okay, so under the buttons also we have a three types of the buttons. Okay, so one is a normal button and second one is a split button. So when you click on that, it will give a pop up down. Second one, third one is the flyout button. When you mouse over the on button, it will give you some pop up window. Okay, so here it's a menu section, it's a menu we can able to add it. So for example, if I want to add a new button to the ribbon, okay, so just select the button and drag and drop it where you need. So just I'm dragging this button on a form level. Okay, so here if you select this one, here the properties it will display. Okay, so this is the ID of this button, and if you want to change the label of the this button, okay, just I'm giving a custom button. Okay, so here we want to some alert text and description and label, okay, tooltip and all we can able to give it. So you can, here we can see this one is needed any template or it's a code command. Okay, so these all the things we can select it. Okay, so this is the simple button I have selected. Okay, so for this button, on click of this button, what action needs to be done? Okay, for that I need to add, create the command. So here the under solution elements you can see the command. So right click and create the command. So it will create the command, and if you select this one, here action. Okay, so here the action I can define it, what action it should be perform. So generally if you select this one, here two type of action. So from here we can able to call it some custom JavaScript method, or we can able to open some website directly URL. If you pass the URL, we can open in a separate website. So for example, if I given some website, so So if I given this one, if you click on OK, so on click of that button, so whatever the URL I have given, so that website it will open. Okay, so this is the button creation, simple button creation. So I will explain one more time. Okay, so for example, if you want to create a new button, so just click on that button and drag and drop it here. So here, if you come to the in the left hand side, it will show the all the properties. Okay, so here we can change the label and name of the button and all. Okay, so next one, the for this button we have to define an action. For this actions we have to create a command. Right click and click on a new. It will create a new command. Click on this command. Okay, here it will display the actions and display rules and enable rules. So first we will see the actions. Click on actions. So it will give an option, add. So if you click on an add, it will ask the JavaScript function or open URL action. So JavaScript method, JavaScript function is we can able to call the our custom JavaScript method. And open URL means if we can able to open a separate directly some website and all. Okay. So this is our defined, we added a button and we have defined. So once we done this all the things, so we want to publish it. So just click on a publish. So it will publish. Okay, so my custom button is added, it is published. Okay, so just go to the sale, so in contacts, so if I click on new, so our customizations is not published properly. Just we need to refresh it again. Okay. So click on the control F5, it will refresh. So here see, still it is not available. Okay, so then sometimes you will face the same issue. Okay, at the time we have to publish it. So here this button, if you see this button, we are not tagged any command, so that is the reason it is asking. So if we have created a command action and we are not mapped to this button. So here whatever the command we have created, we have to select here under the behavior. So then publish it, it will display for you. Okay, so now we go to the here. Just refresh it. So now it is published. Okay, so now we can able to see the this is a custom button. If one click of this one, okay, actually it is loading this one. Okay, so this is the window it is loading. Okay, so this URL whatever it is showing, it is some internet is preparing something here. So we have to especially we have to specify the URL name. Okay. So this type of the we'll create a button here. So in the tool backgroundly it will prepare the all the XML related to the ribbon definition XML. Okay. So if you don't want to use the tool, we have to prepare the XML like this. Okay. So if you do the any small mistake here, so your solution will not import. So that is a very difficult. So that is the reason the most of the times we will use the Ribbon Workbench tool only. Okay. So next level, we have just given the command, just open URL. Okay, so for calling the web, some JavaScript method in the URL. Okay, for that first we need to create a web resource, or we can use it the any existing web resource. Okay, for that we can again we can go for this. Solutions. So open the Ribbon Workbench. This is the one. Ribbon customizations. So click on the web resources. Just I am adding the existing one. Okay. So just I am using this one. New account. So just open this one. You can just define any method, which is method you want to call from there. Okay, so here just I'm creating another method. Okay, function. So the function always should be small. Function So just I'm giving a button. The method name I'm giving a button. So here inside that, just I'm giving a some alert message. Alert custom button. Okay. Okay. Click on okay. Save and publish. Again, open the ribbon workbench. So click on the ribbon workbench. So ribbon customizations. Okay, so here the command, whatever the command. So if you click on this one, okay, so you can able to see the command name. So new contact, new dot contact dot command. So here we can see the commands. So just open. So click on actions. Okay, here just remove existing one. Okay, for time being I am using the same button. Okay, click on add. Here you can select the this one JavaScript function action. So if here we have to give the method name, so same method name, whatever the method we have to give, and here select the what is the JavaScript file. Okay, here there is no JavaScript files for this solution. Okay, so again we need to load the again solution. So click on this one, this one. Okay. And open this one. So here display name is a blank. That is the reason only it is showing. It is not showing. Account save and publish. So this I'm opening a ribbon workbench. Just I'm close this one. Okay, here just if you click on this one. So ribbon customizations, open the solution. Commands, so select the button commands. Here this command. Okay, so here I have this one already, one just I'm removing. So here click on add. So select the JavaScript thing. Okay, here what are the function name we have given, so that function name, and here this is a library, you can select it. Okay, so click on OK, publish it. So once the publish is done, we go to the contacts. Click on menu. So here if you click on this one, our alert it should show. So here it's showing the our alert method. So that means, so our custom JavaScript method is got executed. Okay. So like that we can create the buttons in a MS CRM, in the ribbon buttons in a CRM. Okay.